怎么搞的，连这个横帘都给它搞断了，这种安全问题啊，看人家，这种不行哦，这种不行哦，这种，连这种横帘都全部搞断了。
On the night of May 18th, a 28-story residential apartment building in Longgang District, Shenzhen, made strange noises and wobbled, frightened the residents. They hastily evacuated the building. Some residents promptly called the police. I was sleeping at the time, and I suddenly heard loud noises in the building, like something was hitting the wall. I quickly put on my clothes, ran to the balcony and saw that many people were rushing out of the building. I didn't dare to think too much, so I grabbed my wallet and phone and followed others to go downstairs, said Mr. Dunn, who lived on the 10th floor of the building. I was watching TV at the time when I suddenly felt the floor shaking and the TV began swaying. I thought there was an earthquake, so I quickly ran to the door and saw that many neighbors were running downstairs. I followed them, feeling very scared, said Miss Lee, who lives on the 8th floor of the building. On May 19th, the Longgang government's official announcement stated, around 11:30 p.m. on May 18th, residents of the Baifuxing Tower in Longgang Street reported unusual noises and vibrations in the building. All the residents in the building were evacuated. Experts initiated building structure risk monitoring and safety evaluation, and the cause is under investigation. As of the time of reporting, official news stated, experts are still comprehensively inspecting and monitoring the structural safety of the tower, and no significant tilting or other serious anomalies have been found. The cause is still under further investigation. Public information shows that Baifuxing Tower is located at number 2334 Bingxing Road, Longgang District, Shenzhen. It is a high-rise residential building housing about 500 households. Construction was completed in 2000. The design lifespan of residential apartment buildings in China is 50 years. However, this particular building experienced unusual noise and vibrations after only 23 years of use, leading many netizens to question whether it is a Tofu Dreg project. This high-rise building shaking incident also reminds many of the scene from May 2021, when a 356-meter-tall SEG plaza in Shenzhen wobbled violently, causing 15,000 people to evacuate in panic. The SEG plaza is a landmark building in Shenzhen, once achieving the Shenzhen speed record of constructing a floor within only 2.7 days. It was also completed in 2000 and experienced severe shaking just 21 years into use. The expert team organized by Shenzhen Housing and Construction Bureau announced the results of their investigation, attributing the wobbling of the building to the resonance between the mast at the top of the building and the building's main body under the influence of wind. However, the general public does not agree with the reasons given by so-called experts. They believe that there are serious problems with the quality of the construction. Some netizens commented that these buildings have been around for more than 20 years before wobbling started, which is not the worst scenario, as some buildings have collapsed whilst under construction. On April 12, 2022, the basement of Xiangyuelan City, a residential project under construction in Lanxi City, Zhejiang Province, collapsed. Videos circulated online clearly showed structural beams bending, columns bursted and tilted, and horizontal beams severely fractured, indicating serious structural damage. The official report stated a partial collapse of the ceiling with an area of about 180 square meters. On May 23rd, a video released by the owners of Reishang Huahong Villas in Rayan City, Zhejiang Province, revealed that the load-bearing columns and beams in their apartment suites were fake. Quality issues with residential buildings are pervasive in China. Incidents range from buildings collapsing during construction phase, tilting, water leaking, external wall cladding being blown away by the wind, and even floors punctured by ladies' heels. In 2022, the Guanghuaya residential project in Gu Village, Baoshan, Shanghai, was nearing completion. However, homeowners discovered that some external walls were severely uneven, bulging, and cracking. The fire stairs had started leaking, and the designed solid wall beside the elevator had been replaced with handrails. On December 15, 2022, the homeowners went to the headquarters of Shanghai Real Estate Group, which is a state-owned enterprise and the controlling shareholder of the developer, to complain. But they were dispersed and taken away by the Pudong Public Security Bureau police. Some homeowners were even forcibly detained. In Wuhan, Ms. Zhen purchased a new apartment suite in Polyue Mansion for 1.45 million yuan. 5 months later moving in, the external wall started cracking and falling off. Many homeowners complained to the developer about quality issues, but did not get the issue resolved. They spontaneously hung banners on their balconies to protest, only for the developer to tear them down on May the 12th. Ms. Zhen said that this was one of the most expensive properties in the area, and the poor quality of the houses built by Poly, a big brand, did not match its reputation.
它是这个地区的楼盘最贵的一个楼盘，然后还是很多业主就买了。对于它这个品牌来说的话，它做的房屋质量没有这么符合它作为一个大品牌的形象。看在干嘛？
So why are there so many tofu dreg projects in China's real estate industry, leading to significant losses for homeowners? What are the reasons behind that? One important reason lies in problematic project management. Developers prioritize high-speed capital turnover, seeking to quickly purchase land and start pre-sales for the next project as soon as possible to maximize profits. For each residential development project, pre-sale funds are held in a special bank account under the bank's supervision. However, after developers receive funds according to construction progress from the bank-supervised account, the funds are not necessarily used for the current project, but could be used to buy land for other projects or divert it elsewhere. What happens to the current construction project then? The common practice within the industry is to accrue debts. Developers owe builders, who in turn owe suppliers and workers. In the pursuit of maximum profit, developers strive to reduce construction costs through design optimization, first lowering the safety factor in construction design to lower the cost estimate as much as possible. They then choose the construction companies and building material suppliers with low quotations through bidding. Both developers and builders, aiming to minimize costs, often purchase substandard construction materials. Often, after a construction company wins a bid, it subcontracts the project, sometimes through multiple layers. The final construction company, when organizing the workforce, employs large numbers of untrained migrant workers to save costs and withhold their wages. Another significant reason lies with the Chinese Communist Party's government at all levels. Ren Zeping, vice president of the China Private Economy Research Association, stated in an article, "A study was conducted based on 11 cities, including Beijing and Shanghai, to account for the composition of housing prices. Land costs accounted for 40.1% of the housing price, and tax costs accounted for 16.7%, meaning the government took nearly 60% of total housing price. In 2015, the cost of land in Shenzhen accounted for more than 70% of the total housing price. According to statistics, income from land sales by local governments has consistently accounted for more than 40% of total fiscal revenue. As a result, the government hopes to sell more land to developers. Essentially, real estate developers are accomplices to the government in plundering the wealth of the people." Protected by governmental power and coupled with the inaction of banks that should bear supervisory responsibilities, real estate developers can freely divert project funds to buying more lands, launch more projects, and start more pre-sales to maximize profits. At the same time, home buyers, the common public, are the most vulnerable group. Their rights are violated, and there is no place for them to seek justice. Neither the government nor law enforcement and judicial departments will stand up for them. They can only appeal to developers who might ignore them, disperse them with the help of the police, or even detain them. There is no fairness or justice to speak of in Chinese society. The police and even military are instruments of the Chinese Communist Party to maintain its power. In summary, throughout the entire process of housing development, construction, sales, and use, the government focuses on selling more land, developers aim to obtain more pre-sale funds for houses, construction firms strive to withhold the wages of migrant workers, material suppliers aim to sell low-quality materials. Only the end users of the apartment units, the homeowners, genuinely care about the construction quality. Yet, like those pitiful migrant workers, they are the least able to protect their rights. Some might ask, what about construction supervision? In most cases, engineering supervision is useless in China. The supervision company is also selected through bidding, and supervision companies often lower their supervision costs to win the bid. Since the direct costs of supervision companies are minimal, many consist of personnel wages. They often employ temporary contractors as on-site supervision engineers to cut costs, which results in weak responsibility. This situation has pervaded the entire construction industry. Some developers think that supervising engineers are not needed on site during ordinary times. At completion milestones, such as pre-settlement inspections, it suffices for supervising engineers to show up and sign off documents. It is just a procedure as long as their signatures are on the documents. The low supervision fee results in low remuneration for supervising personnel, which in turn leads to difficulty retaining high-quality talents in the supervision industry. The shortage of high-quality talents in the industry leads to low service levels, which in turn leads to construction units' unwillingness to pay reasonable supervision fees. The supervision industry has fallen into a vicious cycle of lowering fee standards, lowering service level, which leads to further lowering of fee standards. Even when there are issues with the quality of the construction, it is very difficult to hold the supervision companies or individual supervisors accountable. Most supervision companies are owned by government agencies or run by state-owned enterprises. The real bosses behind them are governmental entities, and some have the support of officials. Therefore, when issues arise in the quality of the projects, it is challenging to pursue responsibility. In such a system, the emergence of Tofu Dreg buildings in residential projects is inevitable. In China, not only Tofu Dreg projects are common in residential projects, this problem is also common across all types of construction projects. On the morning of May 16th, a netizen posted a video claiming that a leak occurred in the Dalian Bay subsea tunnel in Dalian City, Liaoning Province. In the video, a woman was exclaiming about the leakage in the subsea tunnel while carefully following the vehicle ahead. According to the video, water was constantly seeping out from the tunnel wall. There was considerable accumulated water on the road surface, and vehicles were slowly passing through it. In another video, stagnant water was clearly visible inside the tunnel, and the vehicles were moving slowly. This tunnel was only open to traffic on May 1st, 2023. At 9:40 p.m. on February the 19th, the surface of the Buto Bridge in Bubu District, Hezhou City, Guangxi Province, collapsed, causing the entire front wall and part of the side wall of the bridge to fall from the top of the arch seat, presenting a terrifying scene. The local government spent 14 million RMB to build this bridge, which was opened in 2015, and it collapsed in less than 8 years, leading to public doubts about whether it was a Tofu Dreg project. On February the 15th, 2022, a river embankment project in Yantan village of Hunan province was questioned for being a Tofu Dreg project, attracting public attention due to quality issues. In the video, clumps of soil would fall when the embankment was prodded with a bamboo stick. The videographer commented, "This is truly Tofu Dreg, all piled up with mud, and it breaks as soon as you poke it with a stick." It was reported that the entire embankment repair project was about 2 kilometers long, with roads and houses built on top of it. Due to years of lack of maintenance, local authorities started the Dongtang Lomen Mouth Cement Embankment Repair Project in the second half of 2021. There are frequent occurrences of Tofu Dreg projects in China, with issues existing in engineering design, project management, construction management, quality supervision, etc. The root cause of all these problems lies in the system of the Chinese Communist Party. The CCP implements a centralized dictatorship decision-making mechanism from top to bottom. In various levels of government, research institutions, universities, and companies, there's a one-size-fits-all mode. It's common for non-professionals to lead professionals. The non-professional leader sets the direction, and the subordinates cannot express doubts or dissenting opinions, only considering how to execute the directive. Even if a directive is technically infeasible, as long as it is decided by the leader, it must be carried out. Therefore, all levels of leadership promoted within the CCP essentially only follow orders from above, no matter how absurd or illogical these commands may be. Hence, as long as the CCP exists, Tofu Dreg projects in China will not disappear.